Clinical trials are fundamental to the development of innovative, investigational products, such as drugs or medical devices. Many products are found to be safe and effective in bench testing, in vitro testing, or animal studies, but fail to demonstrate the same effect in humans. These investigational products must be proven safe and effective in a clinical study in humans before use in the general population. Drug development is often complex, time-consuming, and resource-intensive. It requires particular attention to ensure the appropriateness of the clinical trial being conducted for the drug or biologic. Clinical studies that support regulatory submissions are expected to be adequate and well-controlled. The clinical study reports should provide sufficient details of the study design, conduct, and analysis to determine whether there is substantial evidence to support the claims of effectiveness of the investigational product. The characteristics of such a study may include: study objective and analysis method. Document this in the clinical study protocol and report. Study design. Design with a valid comparison to a control, for example, placebo, dose comparison, active, no treatment, or historical controls, to provide a quantitative assessment of the product's effect. The clinical study design, including treatment duration, whether treatments are parallel, sequential, or crossover, and whether the sample size is predetermined or based upon interim analysis, should be included in the protocol and the report. Subject selection method. Use a method that provides adequate assurance that the subjects have the disease or condition being studied, or evidence of susceptibility and exposure to the condition against which prophylaxis is directed. Patient assignment method. Use a method to assign patients to treatment and control groups that minimizes bias and assures group comparability regarding pertinent variables such as age, sex, severity of disease, duration of disease, and use of therapy other than the investigational product. Assignment is normally by randomization, with or without stratification, in a concurrently controlled clinical study. Minimize bias. Take adequate measures, for example, blinding, to minimize bias on or by subjects, observers, and data analysts. Assessment method of subjects' response. Use a method that is well-defined and reliable. In the clinical trial protocol and report, include the variables measured, the observation methods, and the criteria used to assess response. Product effect analysis. In the clinical trial protocol and report, include the results and analytic methods, as well as any statistical methods. The analysis should include information such as the comparability of test and control groups regarding pertinent variables and the effects of any interim data analyses performed. Uncontrolled or partially controlled clinical studies are generally not acceptable as the sole basis for approval of claims of effectiveness. Such studies that are carefully conducted and documented may provide corroborative support of well-controlled studies regarding efficacy, and may yield valuable data regarding the safety of the test product. Isolated case reports, random experience, and reports lacking the details that permit scientific evaluation are not generally considered. For medical devices, frequent innovations in the design and use, for example, minor modifications that enhance safety, reliability, patient comfort, or ease of use, are common and often do not require prior regulatory approval. Bench and or animal testing is often sufficient to validate the suitability of a design change. In cases when a clinical trial is required, for example, for high-risk or some medium-risk devices, evidence can come from sources other than well-controlled clinical studies, when justified. Such sources may include partially controlled clinical studies, clinical studies and objective trials without matched controls, well-documented case histories conducted by qualified experts, and reports of significant human experience with a marketed device. The reason for these varied sources of evidence is that the design of medical device clinical trials may present some special challenges that do not arise with drug trials. The challenges in designing clinical trials for medical devices include: devices are primarily used by healthcare professionals. The clinical outcomes of a medical device's safety and effectiveness are a function of the user's skill paired with the device-patient interaction. Having training in the use of the medical device is a key part of its clinical performance. Inability to blind the user or patient. Medical devices are often designed differently, and this can introduce bias into the assessment of the clinical performance if the clinical investigator is jointly responsible for treatment and assessment of performance. Thus, whenever possible, blinded evaluators are preferred to clinical investigators for the assessment of efficacy. Limitation in comparative trial design, for example, an implanted device. Comparative clinical trials may be precluded due to ethical considerations. The use of historical controls in the trial or patients as their own controls, such as pre- and post-surgery, may be required to evaluate outcomes. Often, the process for regulatory clearance or approval for medical devices is more flexible than it is for drug development. In summary, in drug development, the replication of clinical findings, that is, more than one clinical trial, is required. However, for medical devices, sometimes a single pivotal clinical trial can suffice, because the mechanism of action is a result of product design and can be substantially verified by in vitro performance testing. Certain lower-risk medical devices do not require a clinical study.